Hey everybody, Ogre here again for Ogre Breaks. Today I'm opening up some of the 2020 first edition Bowman Draft. I bought 10 packs of these. I wasn't too sure how heavy I wanted to go into it, especially at the retail price of $15 per pack. So I bought 10, kind of debating on what I want to do with them. So I'm gonna open up five. I figured five of them I definitely want to open. 10 of them I may wait and hold off till maybe to open them with something else, or I'm not too sure what I want to do yet with them. But you could basically just buy these by either the individual pack, and then but if you bought 24 of them, then they sent you them in a box. Part of the thing too I wasn't too crazy about too was, since I bought these individual packs, I don't know if you can kind of tell, but the packs itself, the foil, kind of looks like they did kind of a crappy job with it. But so I don't know if you guys, anybody else out there that's purchased some of these, kind of got the same thing. But like pretty much all the packs are that way. They just came in a, bubble wrap envelope. And then they were in there. And then, here you go, got the odds for them. You got your pink, or your base parallels. Sky blue is 1 out of 2, blue foil 1 out of 7, yellow foil 1 out of 14. And then, there is a chances for the autographs where, refractor ones are 1 in 377. So like I said, I'm going to open up five of these now and kind of go from there. So, these are the Bowman Draft, the first edition. So they, they do usually tend to have a little higher of a price tag, even on the resale market too. But, so with that, we're going to start with Daniel Espino. We have C.J. Abrams. Then we do get a Aaron Shortridge, numbered 14/25, orange. Not too bad there. Nice getting, some sort of colored card in general. So, I'm not expecting an autograph. If I got an autograph out of this, that'd be, fantastic. It's nice to get a little bit of a color. But then we do have a Bowman first of Gage Workman. Then we have a Bowman first of Christian Chamberlain. Then we have another Bowman first of Casey Martin. Then we have a Quinn Cotton for the Reds. Then we have a Liam Norris for the Diamondbacks. Tyler Brown for the Astros. And Bryson Scott. I'm gonna sleeve up all these cards off camera unless there's a name that that I definitely know of that needs to be sleeved, and of course any color ones too I'll sleeve off camera. But we got Chris McMahon Bowman first, then we have a Carson Tucker Bowman first, and then we do have a blue of Christian Chamberlain, which we did get in the previous pack. That one is numbered 53/150. So, sharp looking card. It is a Bowman first, which is nice as well too. Unlike the Shortridge, which the Shortridge is a name I know of, but I can't really tell you anything about. The Chamberlain, not too sure. I mean, I'm sure some of these guys may have been. Yeah, so he was a fourth round draft pick in this year's draft for the Royals. So. So some of these guys will be draft picks of this year. Then we have Anderson Coffey, Bowman first for the White Sox. We have Andrew Vaughn, nice prospect for the White Sox as well. We have Xavier Edwards, another guy that I'm really high on personally for the Rays. Then we have Casey Schmidt, Bowman first. Then we have Jordan Inwago, Bowman first as well for the Cubs. Then we have Jackson Kowar and Max Meyer Bowman first for the Marlins. So, a lot of these guys, I'm not going to, go through each individual card. I'm not trying to, make this video too long. But, any of you guys that I know of, definitely. Then we have Junior Encarnacion, Justin Foscue, Bowman first. And we do get a red, which is actually very nice. We got a Kyle Isbell, not a Bowman first, but it's a number 1/5. So not too bad there. He was a third round pick in 2018. So didn't I kind of looked to see when he was drafted and stuff, but I didn't really look, you know, numbers wise, 284 career in the minor leagues, batting average, not horrible. You know, 14 home runs, and you know, not really a power hitter either, but he is just an outfielder, so nobody real crazy, but you know, still, it's nice getting a, you know, a card numbered to five, and especially being, you know, numbered one out of five, you know, is really nice. So then we got Ryan Rolston for the Colorado Rockies. Then we have Austin Wells, Bowman first for the Yankees. He was their first round pick this year. Then we have O'Neill Cruz for the Pirates, Jordan Blablich, Hans Kraus for the Rangers, Jackson Miller. Then we have Ronnie Mauriciano, so for the Mets. So nice little, you know, personal pull here for myself, me being a Met fan. So pretty happy so far with, you know, what we got. You know, no huge prospect names. A couple of names, you know, are decent names in my opinion. But you know, they still have, you know, they don't have the quite the. The potential, you know, some other players. So we have Alika Williams, Bowman first for the Rays. Then we have Nick Busco, Bowman first for the Rays as well. Then we have Jack Blomgren, just a parallel of his, not numbered, but it, you know, Bowman first as well. So I mean, I always like. I'm always happy if we can get, you know, like Bowman first cards of any of these guys. Cause you know, I mean, realistically, I mean, you know, when they get drafted, you know, they play in the minors, you know, there's plenty of guys that, you know, they turn out to be, you know, superstars, even late round picks. So then we got JJ Bleday, nice young prospect for the Marlins, who I would assume should be up next year. Francisco Alvarez, catcher prospect for the Mets. Then we have, Adam Seminaris, Bowman first for the Angels. Then we have Jared Jones for the Bowman first for the Pirates. Case Williams for the Rockies, Bowman first. Josh Jung, nice prospect for the Rangers. And then Ed Howard, Bowman first for the Cubs. So, you know, it's nice. You know, I always like getting Bowman first cards. Like I said, you just never know, you know, what can come. You know, out of some of these players, but we got Bailey Horn, Bowman first for the White Sox, Corey Lee for the Astros. Then we have another Carson Ragsdale, foil, not numbered, but you know, he was a fourth round pick in this year's draft, so not too bad there. As I just need to pull out some sleeves here, putting up a little bit of a fight on me. So, not bad. Definitely take, you know, especially Bowman first, you know, the first editions, you know, basically it's, you know, realistically, you know, their very first card. So not too bad there. And I didn't really look to see, I don't remember if I did look. So yeah, Blomgren was the fifth round pick, of this year's draft for the Rockies. So, still, you know, you never know. Then we have Ian Bedell for the Cardinals, Bowman first. Colt Keith for the Tigers, another Bowman first. Trevor Havneau, Yankees, Bowman first. Then we have Quinn Prestier for the Pirates. Freddie Zamora, Bowman first. Zach Daniels for the Astros. And then Milan Tolentino for the Indians. So, I'm pretty sure most of these Bowman firsts, a lot of them will have been drafted this year. So, you know, save, you never know. You know, these are all players that you never know really realistically what can happen. You know, so with that, you know, I'm going to sleeve all these off camera. You know, we did get some nice numbered hits. I'm happy that with the parallels that we got, three of them are Bowman firsts. So I'm happy with that. You know, it's nice pulling one that's, you know, numbered one out of five, you know, and then plus, you know, another one that was pulled, you know, to 25. So, So, you know, like I said, pretty exciting to pull those. And then, you know, we'll kind of see, you know, what we make out, you know, with. And then, you know, I'm going to kind of debate on, luckily the card also too, you know, I do want to say too, the cards, they all looked in pretty good condition. Even though the packaging looked not the greatest, I didn't really notice anything wrong with, you know, too many of the corners. I'll look at them closely or when I sleeve them. But so with that, I want to thank everybody for watching. Please leave a like on the video. Subscribe if you haven't already subscribed. I appreciate it if you did. Hit that notification bell for any future videos I have. And as well, you know, leave any comments. Let me know, have you guys opened up any of these packs? I know they were limited to online only. They were $15. I think they sold out within a couple of hours of being posted, if I remember correctly. But I was able to jump on. I ordered 10 myself, you know, so like, and you know, these packs, you know, 10 card pack, $15 per pack, you know, $1.50 a card, so, you know, is cost. So with that, thanks again for watching, and I will see you next time.